Kevin Knight, thank you for joining us. It's a pleasure to have you every year, as always. We do appreciate it so much. What's in your mind? What are the three key takeaways that you want the participants to take away from your session today?
Well, one is that risk is a management discipline rather than just to do with insurable loss or loss control. That's, I think, a very important thing. And that's why the emphasis is on the management of risk using a risk management process. The other thing is that, as was evidently demonstrated in the first session, that risk is both positive and negative. So we need to look at risk as a neutral term and how do we manage it. Some of it obviously has downsides, but there are lots of risks that we need to take if we can really achieve our objectives. And so it's that understanding of the two. And the other thing is that the role of the risk management practitioner is that of an advisor, a facilitator, a coordinator. The one thing I would love to get rid of is the term risk manager, because that immediately says, oh, to a line manager, I don't have to worry about risk, that's their problem. But at the end of the day, it's the line manager who has to manage the risks.
Thank you. And today you talked a lot about the evolution of the risk management standard in the world, starting with different individual national standards and all coming together in 2009. And the big thing that happened in 2009 is that ISO 31000 introduced principles. And as we speak now, the ISO standard is undergoing some changes due to the work of the Technical Committee 262. Now, how are the principles changing?
Essentially, they're not changing, they've looked at consolidating. And so originally, if you go back to the 2009 edition, we said that the first principle was add value. Well, no, it's add value in add and protect value. So it's not as though we're changing the principles, but we're refining the principles to more clearly consolidate them. We're emphasising that those principles feed into the board and to the top management so that it becomes part of the management system of the organisation. So that again also is important then to take into account.
So it's one of the big themes that's coming out, and that has been mentioned a number of times in this conference as well, is that integration into how business operates, integration of risk management into how business operates, seems to be where we are going. And that is that aligned with where the ISO
is? That's absolutely critical. You know, the whole concept of 31000 is that it's to encourage line managers, the accountable manager, the risk owner, if you will, to actually manage the risk. So therefore, it needs to be integrated into the structure of the organisation. But I think the other thing is to remember is that it's focusing on the corporate objectives. So whatever the risks are that I have to manage in my particular part of the business, I need to always be saying, what do I have to manage in order to ensure that I maximise my contribution to the corporate objectives? Whereas too often we sit and look at what our risks are, and that becomes the centre of the universe, when in actual fact, some of the things that we're worrying about have no impact on the corporate objectives, so we don't need to be doing that. The other thing is for the likes of the service people, like HR, finance, they have lots of risks that they'll suggest, but in actual fact, their role is to clearly facilitate and help the managers manage their risks. So they're there as a service rather than as an entity in their own right. I think that's one of the big takeaways that people need to look at. But 31000, we always designed it as a document that was to be picked up and was to be integrated into the organisation and tailored to meet the needs of the organisation, the structure of the organisation.
Thank you very much for that, and I just wanted to maybe take a quick direction change. What, given the changes that are happening in the world of risk management, what advice would you give to the young risk management population, to the people that are getting from audit to finance, that are just starting their career in the space of risk management?
It's a thing that worries not just with risk management, but with management in general. We're increasingly becoming specialised. Now that's fine, but as you climb up the ladder, you suddenly get to a point where you become a generalist. But where have you got your training? So you've got to start to develop that general understanding, that widen your experience, your understanding of activities, so that you're able to actually bring a broad view rather than a narrow specialist view. Yeah. And that's the thing. One thing that worries me increasingly with young people is that they don't keep themselves informed of current affairs. The business pages and newspapers are considered very old fashioned, but you need to look at things like major newspapers that give you long stories on how things are developing in both politics but in business and that, so that you have a broad understanding and you're then able to talk to either marketing or the finance or the production or whatever, and you've got some understanding of where they're coming from. Whereas if you just have a very narrow specialist view, particularly at audit, you're not able to give benefit to the organisation. So my plea to anyone in audit or risk management starting out is become a generalist, broaden your experience, your knowledge, so that you are in fact able to work with all the facets of the organisation.
That's a very good point. And just to end on a lighter note, what is this one book that you would recommend?
Oh, Against the Gods.
It's a good
thing. The simple reason, that's a primer. That really takes you through the history, and it gives you that understanding of how you've got to have a broad knowledge. Mm-hmm. It's no good being a specialist in numbers or a specialist in safety. You've got to be a generalist.
Yeah.
And that's the only way that a good risk management coordinator, advisor, whatever, is able to actually add value to the organisation.
Thank you very much for taking the time and speaking to us.
Thanks, Alex.
Thank you.